like the whole universe in there.
We've had movies based on comic books, novels, and much more. But there are not many shows based on articles and newspapers. In fact, I bet no one thought about turning the New York Times' popular modern love column into a TV series. Well, Amazon did, and since the first season hit our screens, fans have experienced different emotions from these emotional stories about all kinds of love. In an 8-part series about relationships, feelings, betrayals, and revelations, each episode of Modern Love is based on a memorable column entry, using an all-star cast to recount real-life love stories. Since the first season premiered in 2019, fans have been eager for a second season. And with 2021 came the great news of the show's renewal. Today, we're going to show you everything we know so far about the second season of Modern Love. Before we get into the video, don't forget to like this video, hit the subscribe button, and ring that little bell at the corner. You don't want to miss out on any content we post. Firstly, what makes anticipation kick harder than a release date? The second season of the show was first announced in 2019, barely a week after its first 8 standalone love stories premiered on Amazon. Modern Love is one of those shows affected by the global health situation back in 2020. Just as it started production, it was shut down. However, the show started filming again in September 2020. While announcing the return of the series, the showrunner, John Carney, said, "Being given a green light to proceed with Modern Love is a great opportunity for us to continue to tell stories of love while opening up the series into new cities and the world. The possibilities are truly endless. Subsequent seasons can really branch out and dig deep into what it means to love in this complicated world. It's incredible news for everyone involved in the series, and we are dizzy with the possibilities moving forward." He later added, "We are so excited to bring a second season of this series to life. I am so appreciative to be a part of making that happen." Another filming has been wrapped. There isn't a release date yet, but the second season should premiere sometime in 2021. Next up, it is quite unusual that the trailer of the upcoming season isn't out yet, as Amazon is known to release trailers at least 2 months after the show stops filming. And Modern Love Season 2 production was wrapped up for quite a while now. Hopefully, when the release date is announced, we will also get a trailer for the second season. In the meantime, the synopsis will give out some information about the upcoming series. It's all about love, we know that. But what we do not know is that it is not just romantic love. There is the love of family and friends. There is love of oneself. It is all about the different types of love in the world, and that is sure to continue in the second season. Up next, what is a show without a crew? The second season will have itself some amazing directors, John Carney and John Crowley, who is best known for Brooklyn, Marta Cunningham from Insecure, Jesse Peretz from Girls, the duo of Celine Held and Logan George, and lastly, Andrew Rannells of Black Monday, who is helming an episode based on a Modern Love essay he wrote for the New York Times. The second season of Modern Love will also be proudly produced by Amazon Studios, Stored Media Group, Likely Story, and the New York Times. The executive producers will include John Carney, Trish Hoffman, Anthony Bregman, and The Times' Caitlin Roper, and Shuar Sicha. The show's producers are Sean Fogel and Daniel Jones. The editor of the Modern Love column is co-producer. With such amazing minds working together, I'm pretty sure the upcoming season will be emotionally mind-blowing for the fans of this show. Next, let's take a look at the cast members that have brought these emotional stories to life with their amazing talents. Modern Love has a tremendously intelligible cast who are way too thorough with the art of screen presence. Season 1 of the show attracted some big stars like Anne Hathaway, Tina Fey, and Dev Patel. Since the show is an anthology series made up of standalone stories, we can expect to see different faces in the upcoming season. The season will introduce an entirely new cast, and among these new Modern Love stars are Game of Thrones' Kit Harington, Judas of the Black Messiah's Dominique Fishback, The Politician's Lucy Boyton, True Blood's Anna Paquin, and more. Other cast members of the show include Mbenga Akinagbi, The Deuce, Susan Blackwell, Madame Sanctuary, Lucy Boynton, Bohemian Rhapsody, Tom Burke, Mank, Zoe Chow, Love Life, Maria Dizia, Orange is the New Black, Minnie Driver, Cinderella, newcomer Grace Edwards, Katherine Gallagher, Jagged Little Pill, Garrett Hedlund, Mudbound, Telsey Hewen, God Friended Me, Nikki M. James, Book of Mormon, Aparna Nancherla, Corporate, Larry Owens, High Maintenance, Zane Pays, Room 101, 104, Anna Paquin, Flack, Isaac Powell, Dear Evan Hansen, Ben Rappaport, For the People, Milan Ray, Troop Zero, Jack Rayner, Midsummer, Miranda Richardson, Stronger, Marquis Rodriguez, When They See Us, James Scully, US2, Zuzanna Sadkowski, Gossip Girl, Lulu Wilson, The Glorias, Don Wilcherly, Wild Mountain Time, and Gina Yee, Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt. Next up, we'll be taking a walk through the plot of Season 2. Modern Love as We Know It is an anthology series, so there will be no pickup stories from the first season of the series. But we can expect similar tales of love, loss, and heartbreak. No plot lines of Modern Love Season 2 are known yet, but they will certainly be based on articles of the popular New York Times column, so if you want to get ahead, I suggest you read an article digest and read up the love stories firsthand. A statement from the showrunner, John Carney, suggests that the show will branch out from New York to feature different cities and potentially even different countries in sophomore season. The second season of Modern Love will be filmed in New York City, Albany, Troy, Dublin, Ireland, and Schenectady. The new season will premiere this year on Prime Video later this year in more than 240 countries and territories worldwide. Next up, the stories from this column are real, and there are real people out there who have lived these stories. How about you meet some of the real-life versions of the show's characters? That way, you get to untangle their true stories from the show's fiction. Let's start with the first episode. When the Doorman is Your Main Man, this episode is based on the 2015 essay of writer Julie Margaret Hogben, who currently lives in Los Angeles with her 12-year-old daughter, Isabel. She revealed in an interview that the father of her child proposed to her after she told him about her pregnancy, but she declined, and she also added that she never debated whether or not to go through with the pregnancy. To this day, Hogben is still single, and she hasn't been in a relationship since she had her daughter. According to her, her daughter signs her up for dating apps because she wants a distraction for her. The second episode, When Cupid is a Prying Journalist, is based on Deborah Kopakin's 2015 essay of the same name. There were so many things that weren't real about the episode. There was no job interview, no love at first sight, and there was certainly no trip to the zoo, nor did an infidelity scandal cause their separation. Joshua and Kate had met up in college, where they dated till graduation. At the time, Kopakin was interviewing the real Joshua, Hinge McLeod. Kate was engaged to another man, and they had not spoken in years, but the story ended with McLeod showing up at Kate's doorstep 8 years later, just a month before her wedding. She ended her engagement and got married to McLeod. For the next episode, Take Me As I Am, Whoever I Am, we see Anne Hathaway play the dazzling Lexi. It's based on Terry Chaney's 2008 essay, and every detail of it seems to be exceptionally true, from her bipolar diagnosis to the trembling hand with which Lexi applies her mascara before her date. Today, the real Chaney no longer practices law, and she has authored two books. According to her, in terms of her love life, the men she dates usually read her books first as a sort of prerequisite. In her words, "I don't really know if I'm in a relationship. I do love, I am in love, so that's great." And she never heard of the real life Jeff again, even though she still goes to the same grocery store. The fourth episode, Rallying to Keep the Game Alive, followed the marriage of a couple, Anne Leary and Dennis Leary, as they face divorce. What the show didn't explain is that the couple's therapist didn't think they had a bad marriage. Leary told Times, "He pointed out that we would say things negative about each other, but if he said anything even slightly negative about either of us, we would jump to the other's defense." Anne and Dennis recently celebrated their 30th wedding anniversary, and to this day, the couple still play tennis together. The above stories are only half of what the season has. So if you haven't seen the show for yourself, I suggest you check it out to have a first-hand experience of these beautiful love stories. No doubt that the second season will also feature exciting stories just like these. That's a wrap for today's video. Thanks for watching. Make sure you stick around for more exciting content on this channel.